5 scary rooms that should have stayed secret. A couple times on this channel, we have explored doors that should have never been opened, rooms that should have never been entered. But no matter how deep we dig into the internet's depths, we are always finding more and more horrifying rooms nobody should have stepped into. From Reddit's Nope Room to the Lottery Killer's Hiding Spot, these are scary rooms that should have stayed secret. Before we begin, make sure to hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos every day. With that being said, let's begin. Number 5. The Nope Room. Reddit user Colombian Thunder coined the name The Nope Room when he needed a name to describe the first entry on our list. And we've gotta say, it's very fitting. Colombian Thunder realized his home had a secret bunker below it, one that had been sealed off for a long, long time. It was impossible to get into the bunker, so he opted to squeeze his phone through some cracks, nab some pics, and then take a look at the photos to see what was in there. He probably expected nothing more than an empty room, maybe an abandoned chair or two, but what he saw was far, far worse. If you don't like insects, I suggest you look away. If you do like insects, I suggest you get some popcorn, as you're about to have a lovely time. There's a great big knife on the floor, which is already noteworthy. But even more horrifying than that is the sheer abundance of crickets in the place. What makes this room even more chilling is the fact that Colombian Thunder never quite managed to open it. He just managed to look inside, and he'll grow to wish he hadn't. Imagine how unsettling it must be to go to bed at night and just know there's a room in your house you can never get into that's bursting at the seams with crickets. Yucky. Time for the star topic. So we couldn't find the footage of this picture. Maybe there isn't any footage from the picture directly, but check this out. Holy heck, is this real life right now? So from what we see, this room should have definitely stayed secret. Is someone practicing black magic in here, or trying to summon demons? Also, is that a head on top of the furniture? What in the world is going on here? Alright, so I definitely need some help from you guys here. What could this actually be? Someone's darkish decorated room? Or some sort of secret organization's headquarter for demon summonings? Make sure to comment down below with the hashtag #StarTopic, and we will pin the comment that best explains what is being shown in this image. With that said, let's keep things moving. Number 4. Soviet Bunker. Shai is an explorer. He likes to roam the world, finding all sorts of things and filming them for his YouTube channel. It's a fun life. And in mid-2017, Shai hit the absolute jackpot. While wandering through land surrounding an old factory in Russia, the intrepid explorer discovered a small concrete building and decided to take something of a look around. Passing through a pitch black corridor and through two giant metal doors, he was stunned to find himself in a room with fully working electric light and ventilation. And that was only the beginning. This underground bunker in Patrick, Lithuania had not been touched for decades, but was perfectly ready for somebody to move in. There were newspapers, there was food, there were even gas masks, and the walls were filled with instructional information necessary for survival amidst chemical and nuclear warfare. It was the perfect little place to bury yourself away and hide from an impending nuclear apocalypse. There were boxes upon boxes of equipment to aid in survival, some of which dates all the way back to World War II. It was all so pristine, it almost looked like it had been frozen in time for decades. And things get even creepier from there. Despite being questioned about it, the Russian government refused to talk about the bunker, meaning we still don't know why it was constructed or what its purpose was. We can assume it was set up during a time when the fear of nuclear fallout was genuine, but the extent they went to kit this bunker out is extraordinary. So, what exactly were the Russian government planning to use this bunker for? Why did they simply abandon it after the war instead of taking it down? Did they still think they might need it one day, or did they just forget about it? And why don't they talk about it with anyone? What do you think this bunker was being prepped for? And are you as paranoid as us about why the government won't talk about it? Number 3. The Mole Man Tunnels. So we don't exactly have footage related to this one, and it's actually a very different sort of thing to the other stories we have shared in this video thus far, but it is so incredibly strange and fascinating we simply had to discuss it. We all have hobbies, but William Little, who lived on Mortimer Road in Hackney, London, had quite possibly the most unique hobby of them all. When his home was finally opened and people stepped inside, they discovered that he had constructed a network of tunnels underneath his home that were up to 60 feet long. Why? Well, he doesn't know, so how on earth could we? Seriously, he doesn't know. He just did it because he felt like it. He was given the nickname the Mole Man by the locals, and well, it does kind of fit. Hackney Council discovered the network of tunnels under the house, which originally belonged to Mr. Little's parents, in 2006, and evicted him over safety concerns. The council was left with a £408,000 bill after Mr. Little failed to pay for repairs, and the local authority spent money on maintenance and putting him up in a hotel until 2009 while they looked for accommodation for him. Up to 33 tons of debris, including three cars and a boat, were removed from the property after Mr. Little's eviction. The tunnels he had been working on took four whole decades of work. Imagine committing to a project like that for 40 years. He must have really dug digging. Little inherited the 20-bedroom, four-story house from his parents and must have immediately set about digging. Over the next 40 years, he excavated an extensive series of tunnels under his house and the surrounding area. Some wanted to know his secret, whether he was digging to a nearby bank, but he'd tell them. People are asking what the big secret is, and you know what? There isn't one. He was said to have removed an estimated 100 cubic meters of earth, to such an extent that in 2001, the pavement outside Little's house collapsed. Not to sound suspicious, but we highly doubt he was doing it for no reason. It really seems like he was up to something. The question, though, is what? Number 2. The Lottery Killer's Hiding Spot. Some time ago in Florida, a routine inspection of an air conditioning unit led to a truly unexpected discovery. During the inspection, the worker found a wall panel that he felt was just a little bit off. He decided to experiment and applied pressure to it. To his surprise, it clicked free, revealing a secret carpeted walkway, a staircase that had been hidden away for who knows how long. The stairs led to, you guessed it, a secret room. The room contained air vents, wood walls, carpeted floors, power outlets, and a makeshift bathroom with a men's toilet sign. There were even pizza takeaway boxes on the floor, and two license plates hanging on the wall. After sharing footage of the strange discovery online, however, things got even weirder. Yes, seriously. Somebody got in touch with the homeowner with some information. It turns out that the creepiest thing about this room wasn't what was in it, but what used to be in it. The informant told him that the house allegedly belonged to Dee Dee Moore. If you don't know her by that name, maybe you know her better by this one, the Lottery Killer. Abraham Lee Shakespeare was a casual laborer from USA who won a $30 million lottery jackpot in Florida, receiving $17 million in 2006. But then, his incredible luck was about to change. In 2009, his family declared him missing, and in January 2010, his body was found buried under a concrete slab in the backyard of an acquaintance. Dee Dee Moore was responsible for the murder, gaining the nickname the Lottery Killer in the press. Based on what was in the secret room, especially the pizza boxes, it seems safe to assume that this secret room had been Dee Dee's hiding spot for a short while. But, for reasons unknown, Dee Dee left the room, maybe she was picking up another pizza, subsequently leading to her arrest. Based on certain aspects of the hidden room, it really looks like Dee Dee had set herself up for a while. She had the makeshift bathroom, meaning she wouldn't have to slink out of the room when nature called, and the two license plates were personal items that meant a lot to her. She had facilities, she had comfort. That's why it's so strange that she eventually left the room. Number 1. Area 51 Autopsy Room. The Area 51 Autopsy Room footage is some of the most notorious 17 minutes of footage to ever find its way into the world. But what's the true story behind it all? The United States Air Force facility, commonly known as Area 51, is a highly classified remote detachment of Edwards Air Force Base within the Nevada Test and Training Range. The base's current primary purpose is publicly unknown. However, based on historical evidence, it most likely supports the development and testing of experimental aircraft and weapons systems, also known as black projects. The intense secrecy surrounding the base has made it the frequent subject of conspiracy theories and a central component to UFO folklore. So, what does this have to do with secret rooms that should have never been opened? If the stories are to be believed, an anonymous member of the American military stepped into one of Area 51's many, many rooms to find some of his colleagues experimenting on the corpse of a very real and very dead extraterrestrial life form. The very same alien life form said to have crashed to Earth in the infamous 1947 Roswell incident. Many years down the line, the footage of the secret room found its way into the hands of London-based entrepreneur Ray Santilli. In 1995, Ray released the footage in its entirety to the world. Almost immediately, the alien autopsy footage became the source of hot debate and was a huge media sensation. Jonathan Frakes, Riker from Star Trek The Next Generation himself, even hosted a documentary picking apart the potential validity of the footage. People were divided. Did the footage show a very real alien autopsy and confirm the 1947 Roswell crash as real? Or was it a fake thrown together by a man looking for attention? The debate raged for 9 years until Ray Santilli finally admitted the whole thing was a fake. Now, you're probably thinking, if it's a fake, then that means there was no alien autopsy room to keep secret. And if so, surely it doesn't even deserve a place on this list, let alone the top spot. Well, there is actually a chance that, despite the footage being confirmed fake, the secret alien autopsy room may still be real. Confirming his claim, Ray Santilli insisted in 2006 that while the footage was fake, it was a reconstruction of footage he had actually seen. According to his story, he had been shown the actual footage of an actual dead alien in an actual secret room back in 1992. Santilli was desperate to get the footage out to the real world, but disaster struck. The film naturally degraded. It was utterly unwatchable. Only a few frames survived. Santilli knew that if he just told people he had seen the footage, nobody would believe him. They would want to watch the footage for themselves, but he had no footage. It was gone. So, he decided to recreate everything he had seen, as best as he could remember, and release it as the genuine article. So, therein lies our question. Does the alien autopsy room at Area 51 actually exist? When Santilli said there was once upon a time real footage, and his fake is less a fake, but more a faithful reconstruction, was he telling the truth? Is the footage an actual reconstruction of footage that really did exist once upon a time? If so, how accurate is it? Or is it all as fake as my dad when he tells me he loves me? Was there never a secret alien autopsy room at Area 51 whatsoever? Which of these rooms do you wish had remained shut forever? And how would you feel if you had been the one to find them? Also, check out our other cool stuff showing up on screen now. See you next time.